From the Clark Athletic Center here on the campus of UMass Boston, it is UMass Boston women's basketball here on a Thursday night at the Clark. The men's basketball team will follow as well. Back-to-back games against Bridgewater State. First, the Lady Beacons, 8-5 on the year, host the Bridgewater Bears, 8-6 on the season. In a matchup of two teams that are both coming off fairly good wins. For UMass Boston, a 25-point win last time out against Plymouth State behind the red-hot Grace Geary. For Bridgewater State, a MASCAC conference win, 59-52 over Framingham State. As we look at the matchup between these two teams, one thing will really jump out at you, and that is the three-point shooting percentage. Just 21% this season for Bridgewater State. Bears struggle to score. Beacons, numbers-wise, have that better head-to-head matchup, though. Bridgewater State's numbers are a bit in flux because they have won a lot of close games and lost a few lopsided blowouts. The rebounding battle will be a big key for UMass Boston as well with that plus-six margin. Beacons are so good on the glass because of their rebounding leader, Olivia Murphy, who has 9.4 rebounds a game this year for the Beacons. Offensively, Murphy leads the team with 15 points a game as well, though Grace Geary has led the squad in scoring pretty often here recently. Geary also the best playmaker at 3.5 assists a game for the Beacons, and Murphy inside has been strong on the glass. Meanwhile, for Bridgewater State, couple of really key players. Chanel Melton down low, along with Megan Boutelet, who is the top rebounder in the history of Bridgewater State. Broke the record last time out with more than 750 career rebounds. She's also scored more than 1,000 points for the Bears. Get a look at that all-time series matchup between the Beacons and the Bears. Beacons did win last year, though Bridgewater State does lead that matchup 24-6. Beacons had a big win last year, 25-point win down on the road, and you can see it's been even for the last 4 years with this 2-2 record over the four-game stretch as the Beacons have started to find a way to deal with their in-state rivals who had so much historical success against UMass Boston. Take a look at the matchup the last time these two teams played here. That was a Bridgewater State win in 2012, a 14-point win. We got the highlights for you. So that was the last time the Beacons played at home against Bridgewater State. Though remember, the Beacons did win at Bridgewater State by 25 points last season. Take a look at our player to watch today for UMass Boston. We're going to go with Katrina Edwards, the sophomore forward from Springfield for this Beacon squad. A game where she should have some decent success because Bridgewater State's really very undersized. Bridgewater State, biggest starter is 5'10", so on the boards, look for a really good opportunity for Edwards and the Beacons to have success down low and win that rebounding battle. Edwards this year averaging about 4.5 points and about 6 rebounds a game for her career, averaging right around those 4.5 points again and close to 5 rebounds per game. Last year had 8.7 rebounds against this Bridgewater State club. Beacons won on the road Tuesday against Plumas State, a 25-point win. Their last home game came Saturday. It was another one of those Little East games that came down to the wire. Beacons fell in a heartbreaker by 4, and we'll show you the big moments from that one here now on the Beacons pregame show. Tough loss for the Beacons down the stretch there on Saturday, but a big bounce back with that Little East Conference win 74-49 a couple nights ago against Plymouth State. Tonight, it's a non-conference game against the MasCac's Bridgewater State Bears. We'll be back with starting lineups after this on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
Beacons on the track! Beacons on the track!
My name is Tyler Hart.
Beacons on the track!
Being on the track and field team here is great decisions I've made besides coming to UMass Boston. When you train together in that sort of intensity, you build a sort of a bond with people who are training with you, you know. It's like a higher level of friendship. It's like teammates, it's just a different level. My freshman year, I got a Rookie Athlete of the Year. Outdoor for my sophomore year, I was the first time I went to Nationals. When I jump, it's a little difficult considering I have a hereditary disorder known as amblyopia.
There we go.
It's pretty much just a partial blindness in the left eye. The best way to describe it is if you have decent prescriptions for contact lenses, you take one of the lenses out, and then you put your hand over the eye with that lens. That's my vision. I rely more on my steps as opposed to my visual perception of how far away the bar is. And since I can't see out of my left eye, I have to sit on the far left-hand side of the class. Hopefully coach for a few years, coach some high school kids, maybe even coach on a college level as like an assistant coach, and go to PA school, then do a 5-year program and try to get my loans paid back, and then go from there.
Getting set for tip-off here at the Clark Athletic Center between the Beacons and the Bridgewater State Bears. Beacons and Bears will follow in men's basketball after the women's game here at the Clark. We'll have both broadcasts for you here on LittleEast.tv. Take a look at the starting lineups. We'll start with the Bridgewater State starting lineup. It's a really strong starting lineup, led by two down-low players, though they are undersized. Melton and Boudelet have combined to average about 27 combined points a game. Melton is 8th in the MasCac Conference in points per game. And now let the Beacons introduce themselves in their starting lineup.
I'm Tajay Burston. I'm from Springfield, Massachusetts, and I'm a guard.
Grace Geary, freshman guard, Falmouth, Massachusetts.
I'm Mallory Nelson. I'm a sophomore from Topsom, Maine, and I'm a guard.
Winding things down until tip-off here on the Beacons Broadcast Network, UMass Boston, Bridgewater State. We'll step aside shortly here, but first, actually, we'll check the keys to the game. For UMass Boston, the keys really lock in defensively and force Bridgewater State to the perimeter. They do not shoot the ball all that well, just 21.8% from three this year. Beacon should have the leg up in the rebounding battle. They are plus six on the season, whereas Bridgewater State is minus six. Finally, for the Beacons, they need to watch the basketball. Beacons have turned it over about 16 times a game this year. Bridgewater State forces close to 21 turnovers a game. Those are the keys to the game. We'll have that game coming up next. National anthem and tip-off next on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
Hi, my name is Carl Joseph. I'm currently a criminal justice major. I'm a senior. I am from Brockton, Massachusetts. In basketball, I play small forward slash power forward, and in track, I'm a high jumper. Basketball has always been my first love. The favorite part was probably our win over MIT. Like that was tremendous. I almost came to tears just from where the program has come from where I first came here to where we are now. It's just amazing, and I love it. Honestly, I was recruited for basketball. My high school coach actually emailed the track coach here, and she walked into the gym one day, and it was just like, here, you, come talk to me. And I was on the track team. It really wasn't much of a choice. It was a great honor my freshman year, just being able to become an All-American, finishing fourth in my first ever national championship meet. It was quite the time of my life. My junior year, we received our LEC championship rings from our sophomore year. Coming in into my freshman year at UMass, I was able to witness the volleyball team win their championship and the soccer team, and the only thing that I really wanted was a ring of my own.
Here's Joseph knifing through.
Funny thing is, I actually work here as well. I am one of the Zamboni drivers to our men's and women's hockey teams, and that's what I do for part-time. Being a student here at campus, I can honestly tell you, is quite different from anywhere else you could possibly go. Just the student body here is amazing. I mean, the teachers are amazing. All the teachers that I've had never hesitated to help me out in any way that they could have, from extra help to me going into their offices just to talk about what's going on in the classes and to keep me on track. What I want to do when I graduate, I want to go into the police force for a little bit and ultimately end up either working for the Department of Homeland Security or the Department of ICE. It's definitely possible to be a two-sport athlete here at UMass Boston. It's just going to take a little bit of hard work.
Back here at the Clark Athletic Center, again getting set for tip-off between UMass Boston and Bridgewater State. The Beacons are 8-5 on the year, 2-2 in Little East play. The Bridgewater State Bears 8-6 on the season, 2-1 in MASCAC play. Beacons beat this Bridgewater State club by 25 points last year, but Bridgewater State holds a 26-4 all-time advantage in this series. Bridgewater State this year is 2-1 against Little East teams. They beat Rhode Island College and UMass Dartmouth, lost by a couple of points, rather by 18 points, to the University of Southern Maine. Meanwhile, for the Beacons, they're actually 0-2 so far this year against MASCAC schools, with close losses to both Fitchburg State and Westfield State. The Westfield State game coming here at the Clark Athletic Center. Running you through the starting lineups once again, if you're just joining us for Bridgewater State, the starters, Vanessa Consecia, Rachel Cush, Melissa Daigle, Chanel Melton, and Megan Boudelet. Meanwhile, for the Beacons, your starters are Tajay Burston, Grace Geary, Mallory Nelson, Olivia Murphy, and Kirsten Morrison. The five on the floor for the Beacons. And for the first time, maybe in a couple of years, you could say the Beacons lately have had a different go-to scorer than Olivia Murphy, who has still been very solid, still averaging 15 points a game. But Grace Geary has been on fire the past couple of weeks. Two-time Little East Rookie of the Week. She scored a career-high 27 last time out. That's after last week. She had a game where she scored 26 points. So Geary has been red-hot from the outside. And we'll see if the Beacons can use the freshman guard from Falmouth, Massachusetts, here today against Bridgewater State. Bears in red jerseys. They're coached by Bridget Casey, who's in her 18th season as the head coach at Bridgewater State. Beacons under 60-year head coach Courtney Mattingly, a graduate of St. Bonaventure University up in Western New York. Beacons will be back in action again on Saturday in Little East play at Western Connecticut State. For Bridgewater State, their next game will be a home one in MASCAC play against Worcester State. Tip off between Murphy for the Beacons and Boudelet, a center from Charlton, Massachusetts for the Bears. Beacons control it with Nelson. Should have the height advantage all game long, especially with Murphy down low, and she got easy control of that opening tip. Here's sophomore point guard Tajay Burstyn. Entry for Murphy, left block. Doubled immediately, and she travels. Melton and Boudelet combined, and that might be the game plan all game long for Bridgewater State. Double Olivia Murphy to try and take her out of the game. Good news for the Beacons, though, is they still have other players with size, including Kirsten Morrison and Mallory Nelson in this starting lineup. Beacons starting a 2-3 zone defense. Melissa Daigle, a senior guard from nearby Rockland, sends it down low. Boudelet bounces a pass, and Burstyn has the interception. 2-on-1 for the Beacons. Geary slows things down and finds Nelson. Long two. It's good. Strong start for the Beacons. 45 seconds in. A two-point lead. 2-3 zone defense seems like the right way to approach this Bridgewater State team. Again, they shoot just 21% from three. That's in the bottom quarter of the nation. Melton down low. She's fouled. Good pass to her from Rachel Cush. Two free throws coming after Nelson's first foul. First foul on the Beacons as well. Chanel Melton, the sophomore from Brockton, Massachusetts, has some ties to Chantel Jordan, who's also a sophomore from Brockton. Melton's had a very good sophomore season. First free throw is good. Eighth in the MASCAC conference, averaging 12.5 points a game. She's also sixth in the conference in free throw percentage. Shoots about 78% from the line. 2-for-2 trip for Melton as that line drive free throw bounced around and down. All square, a little more than a minute in. For the first time, we see some token pressure, a 1-3-1 zone that'll try to trap here at half court. Geary attacks the lane, out of control shot, and a rebound into the hands of Boudelet, the all-time leading rebounder for Bridgewater State. Good push to the pace, Cush for three, no. Morrison battles for the board, it's still loose, and it ends up in Boudelet's hands again. It's an area where the Beacons should have the advantage. UMass Boston, one of the better rebounding teams in its conference. Bridgewater State, one of the worst rebounding teams in its conference. Another three on the way, and this time no good for Concesia. So an 0-for-2 start from three for Bridgewater State. Sloppy pass from Burstyn. She overled Mallory Nelson. Beacons turn it right back over. Hasn't been much movement for this Bridgewater State club so far. Instead, passing the ball around the perimeter. Looks for someone maybe to flash in the center of the paint. Haven't seen it yet. Concesio is off on the three, and Morrison grabs the board for the Beacons. So far, Bridgewater State settling for three-pointers against the Beacons' 2-3 zone defense, even though Bridgewater State struggles to hit from the outside. Two apiece, 2.5 minutes in. Here's Morrison, who has just a huge height advantage today, 4 inches taller than the tallest player in the Bridgewater State rotation. But the Beacons turn it over for a second time already today. Beacons make a quick substitution. Freshman Katie Matthew from Coventry, Connecticut is the first Beacon off the bench. Matthew this year is playing about 23 minutes a game as a freshman. She averages close to 6 points a game. Great pass inside. Melton is stuffed. Morrison got to her. The Beacons get the board. Melton had possession, but Morrison used her size advantage to get that rejection. Matthew travels. That's three Beacon turnovers already. A fact, that's the fourth turnover on UMass Boston through just 3 minutes. Bridgewater State forces 21 a game, though most of the Beacons' turnovers so far today have been unforced turnovers. See if Bridgewater State can get somebody free at the free throw line. That's really the soft spot in a 2-3 zone defense. Cush finds Melton over Morrison. The hook's no good. Tough matchup for Melton, who gives 5 inches to Morrison in the paint. Geary for the Beacons, 0-for-1 from the floor today, coming off a career-high 27 in the 25-point win over Plymouth State. Beacons are 8-5. Bridgewater State is 8-6 on the season. Just 7 to shoot for UMass Boston. Bounce pass towards Murphy. Extra pass is a beauty, and Morrison has the layup. No panic at all from Olivia Murphy late in the shot clock. She finds Kirsten Morrison for an easy layup. Beacons lead 4-2. Morrison with strong defense. She's been the best Beacon so far through the first 4-plus minutes. Geary pushes the pace right to the rim. There's a foul. No basket. Fouls on Rachel Cush. It's her first on the Bridgewater State Bears. Officials so far have let both teams play just one foul aside in the game's first 4:20. Open corner three, Matthew, it's good! Beacons have the game's first three-pointer. 7-2, UMass Boston. That's Matthew's, one of her specialties. Takes a lot of three-pointers, shooting around 30% on the season. Drive and kick for Melton. Right at Morrison. Melton draws a foul. 2 free throws coming. Now, if Melton's going to have success down low, she's much better off doing that, driving and trying to get Morrison moving rather than lowering her shoulder and working right into Morrison. 2 more free throws for Melton, who has the only 2 points so far today for Bridgewater State, and they're both from the free throw line. Bears are 0-for-5 from the floor. Melton's off on the free throw. Beacons are shooting 3-of-4 from the floor, but they've turned it over 5 times. Bridgewater State 0-of-5 from the floor, 2-of-3 from the line, and they've only turned it over twice. Melton off on both. Beacon rebound right into the hands of the freshman, Matthew. And here's the sophomore from Topsham, Maine, Mallory Nelson, who breaks the timeline. High-low from Morrison to Murphy. Follows her miss, and she's fouled. Those two could play pitch and catch all day, and the Beacons would have a whole lot of success. Not really anybody on this Bridgewater State roster that should be able to match up and bang bodies with either Murphy or Morrison down low. Murphy's first free throw way too strong. Her free throw percentage this year has been so much better than her previous couple of seasons with the Beacons. She's shooting 80% from the line. Misses both on this possession, though, and the honorable mention All-American from last year is still scoreless today. More than a quarter of the way through this first half, still no field goals for Bridgewater State, and here a third turnover. High pass that overshot both Daigle and Melton down low. Consatio and the Bears extend their 1-3-1 defense. They really try to jump right around the free throw line. Nelson drives the lane, into contact, no call. Morrison a follow, and she's fouled. Throw that foul on Consatio, her first. Junior from New Bedford, Massachusetts, has the second foul of this game. Make that the third foul on Bridgewater State. Kirsten Morrison cans the free throw. 3 early points for the 6'2 senior from North Reading, Massachusetts, winding down her athletic career here at UMass Boston over the next couple of months. She's been busy in her time here. A Little East all-conference performer in both volleyball and basketball, playing both sports all 4 years. Beacons by 6. They've held Bridgewater State without a field goal for the game's first 5.5 minutes. That 2-3 zone causing Bridgewater State to do what it really doesn't want to. That's take 3-pointers. Beacons jump the passing lane. A run out for Matthew. No. Geary the follow. Rattles out, and the rebound into the hands of Chelsea Saucier, a sophomore guard from Portland, Maine. Tough break for the Beacons there in transition. Bridgewater State already 0 for 3 from 3. They entered this game shooting just 21% from outside. Down low, Boudelet is too strong. Jumper for Rihanna Page is the first field goal of this game for Bridgewater State. Freshman from Brookline makes it 8-4. Couple good offensive rebounds on that possession for Bridgewater State. Rebounding maybe better than you'd expect. Being out-rebounded 8-4, but still the Beacons have just a huge size advantage. Another Beacon turnover, that's the sixth of this game. It's allowed Bridgewater State to hang around. Hard drive for Daigle. Extra pass, Boudelet. Heel the rim, and Nelson seals out for a Beacon rebound. Timeout, Courtney Mattingly. We'll take a quick one as well. Beacons 8, Bridgewater State 4 after about 7 minutes here on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
What separates UMass Boston from other schools is the fact that a large percentage of students commute. For me, it takes 2 hours each day to go to and from school, but every second has been worth it because the students that come here are serious about learning, they value their education, and understand where it'll take them in the future. This is what UMass Boston means to me.
UMass Boston 8, Bridgewater State 4 through 7 minutes. Here on Beacons Broadcast Network and LittleEast.tv, Bill Spaulding with you at the Clark Athletic Center. UMass Boston's defense has held Bridgewater State to just 1 of 8 shooting in the early going. Beacons are 3 for 8 from the field, but they were 3 of 4. UMass Boston has missed its last 4 shots and turned it over 7 times. Beacons 8-5 on the year. They beat this Bridgewater State team by 25 last year. But the Bears this year are an improved squad, 8-6 on the season. They did win the MASCAC last year to make the NCAA tournament as well. A short three on Matthews' attempt, so she's 1 for 2 from outside today. And Bridgewater State pushes, a touch foul goes on Geary. Grace Geary's first foul, only the third on the Beacons. Bridgewater State, 2 points from Chanel Melton, and 2 more from Rihanna Page. Melton got her 2 at the free throw line. Payne has the only field goal, and she's got another. Rihanna Page with 4 quick points for the Bears. It's a 4-0 run for Bridgewater State. Beacons look for their first field goal in 7 trips down the floor. Nelson, 2, strong on the 2. Beacons are 0 for their last 6 from the field, and that one is straight out of bounds. Chelsea Saucier with a high pass that's out of bounds and leads to another Bridgewater State turnover. That's the 5th turnover for the Bears, who average 19 turnovers a game. Beacons going against that three-quarters court pressure as it's batted out of bounds by Boudelet. So far, the pressure itself has not forced a Beacon turnover, but it does force UMass Boston to use up the shot clock, which leads to less time to work to get a good shot, and oftentimes a hurried pace can lead to turnovers in the front court. Matthew finds Geary. Still hasn't scored yet today. Pretty feed inside. Layup doesn't go for Edwards, and the follow's there for Murphy. First 2 for Olivia Murphy. Honorable mention All-American last year, and the Beacons leader at 15 points and 9.5 rebounds a game. Boudelet with a kick out. Daigle passed on the 3. Long 2 on the way for Saucier. No. Big rebound for Katrina Edwards, the sophomore from Springfield. This is 5-1 sophomore guard Tajay Burstyn, also out of Springfield, a transfer this year from Goshen College. in Towson, Maryland. 10 to shoot for the Beacons. Edwards, high-low with Murphy. Easy bucket. Those high passes to Murphy have set her up for a couple high-quality shots. As again, she has that height advantage on Boudelet, who's been marking her all game long. Beacons have answered four in a row from Bridgewater State with four of their own to build that lead back to six. Boudelet draws a double. Here's an extra pass for Page. Off on the jumper, and Edwards rips away a rebound, but we have a jump ball called. Officials were quick with the whistle there. Possession on the alternating arrow keeps it with Bridgewater State. Fresh shot clock for the Bears. Open baseline jumper, Sauciano. So the Bears are now 2 of 11 from the floor. Anyone not named Rihanna Page is 0 for 8 from the floor in the game's first 9 minutes. Beacons on a 4-0 run. There's an emphatic shot block from Saucier, wiping away the Matthew attempt. Bouncer for Melton. She's doubled. And a foul is called. That might have bailed her out. She was in a tough situation there, doubled between Edwards and Murphy. Foul goes on Edwards, her first, fourth in the Beacons. Third trip to the free throw line for Chanel Melton. She made both on her first trip, missed both on her second. And she rattles this one down. Melton has three, Page has four. That's all of the scoring in the first quarter of this game for the Bears. Beacons 8-5 on the year, 2-2 in Little East play, and looking for back-to-back wins for the first time in the new year. Both free throws caught the back of the rim. The first one rattled down, the second bounces out. So a split for Melton at the line. Beacons won by 25 last time out, a 74-49 win on the road at Plymouth State to get to 2-2 in Little East play. Hard drive. Edwards gets it to go. First two for Edwards. We've got a timeout called by Bridgewater State. 9:37 in. Beacons have scored six of the last seven. They lead by 7 points on LittleEast.tv.
I did receive a non-athletic scholarship upon entering school.
I got the presidential scholarship, which was huge for me.
I think there's more opportunities for academic scholarships in Division III.
I did receive academic scholarships. Just being involved on campus, being a leader, all those things combined kind of get me recognized. It's a great experience for me.
Six-1 run for UMass Boston. Beacons lead 14-7. It's their largest lead of the game. With 9:37 to go in the first half. Beacons 8-5 on the year, Bridgewater State 8-6. This is a non-conference game with the Beacons out of the Little East and the Bears out of the MASCAC. Bridgewater State comes in after beating Framingham State by 7 points on Tuesday. Beacons won by 25 on Tuesday against Plymouth State. Here are the red-clad Bears working against the 2-3 zone. Long jumper for Melton's too strong, and Edwards has another Beacon rebound. UMass Boston really controlling the glass, out-rebounding Bridgewater State 15-9 in this first half. Chance for Olivia Murphy to get a break on the bench. Kirsten Morrison's back out down low, banging in the post, calling for the ball. Edwards finds Burstyn. 8 to shoot for Grace Geary. Tough move in the paint, and the shot doesn't go. It's out of bounds on Geary's crashing rebound attempt. Still nothing today for Geary, who scored a career-high 27 on Tuesday. Like to see that aggression, though. You can tell that she can get to the rim really rather effortlessly, especially for a 5'6 guard. Geary really pressuring high on that 2-3 zone, challenging the perimeter. Entry pass deflected by Morrison and stolen by Matthew. Beacons fourth, a sixth Bridgewater State turnover. Go to work against the Bridgewater State man-to-man. Corner three, Matthew. It's her second of the night. Both of them from the same spot. Beacons have scored 9 of the last 10 and lead by 10 points. Tough thing for Bridgewater State is they really can't match the Beacons 3-for-3. Near the bottom of the nation, shooting just 21% from outside. There's a strong drive by Boudelet, who drew the contact and scored. Just the third field goal of this game for Bridgewater State. Only averaging a field goal every 5 minutes or so. Burstyn traveled. Now it looks like they got a foul first. Burstyn could have been called for the travel, but they roll a foul on Bridgewater State first. It's the second Bridgewater State foul on Chanel Melton, who stays in the game with two fouls and now is subbed out late. So Melton gives way for Boudelet. Bears also send out two other players off the bench, including Consatio, who closed out on the three for Burstyn. Edwards the follow, and a travel is called. Beacons bring in Brittany Moore for the first time today. Moore on the season, senior, 5'11 from Billerica. Hasn't seen a ton of playing time, but again, a height advantage. She should be able to make a pretty good impact in today's game. Beacons force a turnover. Burstyn pushes the pace to the front court with UMass Boston up 8. 7 minutes to go, first half. Geary for three. And the rebound bounces into the hands of Boudelet. Got it going forward. Daigle might have gotten away with a walk. Consatio for the first three of the night. No sir for Bridgewater State. 0-5 from outside. On the interior, Daigle has it batted away. Consatio keeps it alive. 16 to shoot for Bridgewater State. That's a travel. Boudelet thought about the shot, and that hesitation led her to shuffle the feet. Turnover number 8 for Bridgewater State. Beacons had 6 turnovers in the game's first 5 minutes. They've only given it away once over the game's last 9 minutes. 8-point lead for UMass Boston on the back of a really suffocating defensive effort so far. Edwards finds Burstyn. Moore's posting up down low, calling for the ball. Geary has 7 to shoot. Burstyn pumps on a 3. It's a long 2. No good. Edwards the follow, and she's fouled. Now, Katrina Edwards has made an impact inside since she entered the game relatively early on. 2 free throws coming for after the foul on Jillian Sedler, a senior center from Oak Bluffs, Massachusetts. That's down on Martha's Vineyard. Edwards' free throw is good. Yep. Sedler went to Martha's Vineyard Regional High School, and one of the interesting things about Martha's Vineyard Regional High School, if you play sports for them, every road trip is a real chore because you have to hop on the ferry, get back to buses on the mainland in Cape Cod, either in Woods Hole or in Harwich, and then from there, you got to take your bus ride. So a road trip goes from what maybe would be a half hour to an hour for an average road trip for a normal Massachusetts high school team. For Martha's Vineyard, you start talking about a 2 to 3 hour road trip just for the close games, and that's not to mention the cost of traveling a high school team for each and every sport onto the ferry. I've been told they even charter planes, little plane hoppers from time to time for some of their sports teams to go from venue to venue. On the right block, an underhanded layup doesn't go for Boudelet, and a rebound comes right down to Olivia Murphy. Beacons lead by 10. It's a 19-9 start for UMass Boston. Murphy, high-low with Morrison. Layup, no. Morrison's follow draws a foul. That was Sedler who got her again. Second foul on Sedler. Two free throws for Kirsten Morrison, who has scored 3 early points today. Morrison has more than 1,000 career points. Little East All Conference, again in volleyball and basketball, was the rookie of the year for the conference in both sports her freshman year. Morrison made the first, leaves the second short, but Nelson grabs the board. Beacons have their largest lead of the game at 11. Burston with a new shot clock resets the offense. Entry to Morrison is intercepted. Sedler did a nice job getting her hand on that one. Sedler seeing more time than normal today because she is the tallest player on the roster at 6 feet even. And with the Beacons being so good down low, Bridgewater State needs all the help it can get in this matchup. Beacons beat them by 25 last year of an 11-point first-half lead. Jumper didn't go for Saucier, who's had a rough start, 0 for 4 from the field. Bridgewater State's now just 3 of 17 as a team, 1 of 14 for anyone not named Brianna Page. Murphy's tough drive doesn't go. Murphy follows her miss, too strong. Morrison a third try, give it to her. 6 points for Morrison. Timeout, Bridgewater State. Beacons have their largest lead of the game at 13 on the back of really tremendous defense here on LittleEast.tv.
We're here at the police station for getting back to the community, having fun at the Halloween haunted house.
We decorate all the cells, create a haunted house for the kids, and by 9 o'clock tonight, it's back to our actual prison cell again. We reached out to community groups, the local colleges, UMass, they love to work with us. We have a great relationship with UMass, so it was incredible to have the kids and the students come in and help us scare the children.
Halloween is just such a great time of year, and it's great to see all the kids having fun and helping them out.
I'd definitely be back for next year.
UMass Boston's defense has been just tremendous in this game. A 13-point lead. They've allowed just 9 points over the game's first 16 minutes. Bridgewater State is shooting 3 of 17 from the field, 0 of 4 from 3. Bears have turned it over 8 times. Meanwhile, the Beacons are shooting 8 of 24 from the field, and they've turned it over 8 times. But the positive for the Beacons, they're out-rebounding Bridgewater State 23-12 and have 10 offensive rebounds, which has led to 8 second-chance points. Beacons are on a 14-3 run that has taken up 10 minutes of game time, so really maybe you're better off calling it a 14-3 stroll, jog, crawl, anything like that. But nonetheless, Beacons lead by 13 with about 4 minutes to go. Morrison has the 9th turnover for Bridgewater State in her hands, and the Beacons bring it to the offensive end. Morrison can't grab that tough pass from Murphy. Beacons turn it over for a 9th time. Melton runs the floor and lays it home. See if Bridgewater State can do a bit more of that moving forward. They've really struggled against the Beacons 2-3 zone. The best way to beat the zone is to get it up the floor so quickly that the Beacons can't set up the 2-3. UMass Boston still doubling up Bridgewater State. There's an air ball from Matthew, who had hit 2 3-pointers from that same spot. Saucier in the corner, runs into a double team. Tough pass gets to Consatio just in the nick of time. Consatio uses the screen. Here's Page, and she hits another. Where would the Bears be without Rihanna Page today? She's 3 for 4. The rest of the squad is rather 2 for 15. 4 in a row for Bridgewater State. It's a 9-point game. Morrison finds Murphy. No good on the jumper. Beacons aren't lighting the world on fire either. They're just 8 of 26 as a team. Great pass for Melton. She's got it and a foul just like that. 6 in a row for the Bears and a chance to make it a 6-point game at the free throw line. Morrison and Nelson come out. Edwards and Geary return for the Beacons. One more free throw for Chanel Melton, who has 5 points out of the 15 for the Bears. Off on the free throw, she's now 3 for 6 from the stripe today. Geary open for three. Yes, ma'am. First three today for Grace Geary, who scored a career-high 27 last time out. She ends a 6-0 run. Hard drive for Melton. Jumper over Murphy's good. 7 for Chanel Melton, a little more than halfway to her season average of 12.5 a game. Edwards, 1v1 on Melton, takes it to her and scores. Great move by Edwards, and Melton has to be careful because she's already picked up 2 fouls. She's been the best thing going on offense along with Rihanna Page for the Bears. Three-pointer on the way for Saucier. It's now 0-for-6 from 3 for the Bears. Bounce pass from Geary's picked off. Seidler ran the floor, finds Melton on the outlet, and great defense coming back from Edwards to poke it out of bounds and stop the one-on-one. Minute 25 to go, first half, 10-point lead for UMass Boston. Beacons have led from the start. Jumped out to an 8-2 lead before Bridgewater State pushed it back to 8-6. Beacons then at a 14-3 run. And they've been comfortably in front really most of the way. Beacons 8-5 on the year. Bridgewater State 8-6 out of the MASCAC Conference. Consatio hits the first three of the game for Bridgewater State on attempt number 7. First three for Vanessa Consatio, who averages about 10 points a game. 7-point game for the Beacons, who can go 2-for-1 if they use the shot clock correctly here. 21 seconds on the timer. If the Beacons use, say, 15 more seconds, it would force Bridgewater State to have to shoot before the shot clock expires, and it would give the Beacons the ball back for one more shot. Geary is fouled on the floor. That's foul number 7 on Bridgewater State, and a 1-and-1 opportunity coming for Grace Geary. First foul on Paige. Geary's been tremendous from the charity stripe this season, 83.8%, and she gets the front end to go. Played her first 3 years of high school basketball at Falmouth High School, spent last year nearby at Quincy High, where she was an all-state performer. Geary hits both. It's a 9-point lead. Geary was a 3-time league all-star at Falmouth High and then earned league all-star honors with Quincy as well. Bouncer goes straight out of bounds. Geary played at North Quincy, so if you're listening in the Quincy area, apologize for saying Quincy. I know that rivalry is something like Patriots-Jets down there just south of town. They play every Thanksgiving on the football field. Got 35 seconds to go. First half, 10-second difference between game clock and shot clock. Nice play by Boudelet to get her hand on it. She pushes to the offensive end. Hand off for Consatio. And a foul drawn. 2 free throws coming for Consatio as Olivia Murphy is tagged with a foul. It's Murphy's first. It's the second, rather the sixth, on the Beacons. 2 shots here for Consatio, a 67% free throw shooter. Her first is good as Morrison will enter for the Beacons here and Edwards will head to the bench. One positive, the shot clock is off, so the Beacons will be able to hold for the last shot. That is, if they box out for the rebound. They get the rebound with Murphy. Beacons have out-rebounded Bridgewater State 26-14 in half one. 8-point lead for UMass Boston. Geary doubled and she travels. Boudelet bumped her and spun her around. Turnover number 12 in half one for UMass Boston. Bridgewater State can make it a 2-possession game with a bucket here in the final 10 seconds of half one. Geary makes up for the travel with the steal. 3 seconds left. Geary to the front court. Drives the lane and draws a foul with 0.4 seconds to go. That's a tremendous play by Grace Geary, who didn't sulk after the travel. Made a play. So from a chance for a two-possession game to a chance for the Beacons to lead by 10 points at halftime if Geary hits both free throws. Foul was the first of the game on Megan Boudelet. And Geary's good on the free throw. Grace Geary has scored 5 points. They've all come in the last few minutes. She's got both free throws. Didn't even touch the rim on the way through, and the Beacons lead by 10 at halftime. Tremendous defensive half for UMass Boston, and they hold the Bridgewater State to just 34% shooting, just 1 of 5 from three, and the Beacons lead 31-21 as they head to the locker room here at the half. Beacons and Bridgewater State Bears here on LittleEast.tv.
Hi, my name is Carl Joseph. I'm currently a criminal justice major. I'm a senior. I am from Brockton, Massachusetts. In basketball, I play small forward slash power forward, and in track, I'm a high jumper. Basketball has always been my first love. The favorite part was probably our win over MIT. Like that was tremendous. I almost came to tears just from where the program has come from where I first came here to where we are now. It's just amazing, and I love it. Honestly, I was recruited for basketball. My high school coach actually emailed the track coach here, and she walked into the gym one day, and it was just like, here, you, come talk to me. And I was on the track team. It really wasn't much of a choice. It was a great honor my freshman year, just being able to become an All-American, finishing fourth in my first ever national championship meet. It was quite the time of my life. My junior year, we received our LEC championship rings from our sophomore year. And coming in into my freshman year at UMass, I was able to witness the volleyball team win their championship and the soccer team, and the only thing that I really wanted was a ring of my own.
Here's Joseph knifing through.
Funny thing is, I actually work here as well. I am one of the Zamboni drivers to our men's and women's hockey teams, and that's what I do for part-time. Being a student here at campus, I can honestly tell you, is quite different from anywhere else you could possibly go. Just the student body here is amazing. I mean, the teachers are amazing. All the teachers that I've had never hesitated to help me out in any way that they could have, from extra help to me going into their offices just to talk about what's going on in the classes and to keep me on track. What I want to do when I graduate, I want to go into the police force for a little bit and ultimately end up either working for the Department of Homeland Security or the Department of ICE. It's definitely possible to be a two-sport athlete here at UMass Boston. It's just going to take a little bit of hard work.
My name is Allie Greenberg. Welcome back to another episode of Behind the Beacon. I'm your host, Haley Dutton. The UMass Boston women's ice hockey team has had a roller coaster season thus far, starting off the season with a program best 5-game winning streak, followed by a 7-game winless streak. We mic'd up head coach Colleen Harris to see what it's like inside a typical practice.
When you're shooting, shoot to score, okay? Shoot to score. Pick your head up and look, shoot to score. Shoot, shoot! I'm gonna take a Sharpie and draw in the slot. And if they go in the slot and don't shoot, they're getting off the ice. Good, Sarah, one hand, Sarah, one hand, one hand. She is good. She's gonna be fine. Here we go, Berkey. When you're in front, just go one hand no matter what, because if you go like this, you're gonna take away so much more, well, for you it's gonna be like this. You're gonna take away so much more space just because it's one hand. Where are her eyes? Find her eyes and get in front of them. Find her eyes. She's gonna be pissed at me. Uh-oh, something bad happened. One lap. When you recognize a 2-on-1, and you have a 2-on-1, take it, and take the puck to the net. Okay? Let's go. Score some goals. Understand it. Now I know that like it moves quick, and especially with those two, you guys are gonna be quick.
Yeah.
But you're gonna have to, it's more for this drill, it's more of like a thinking thing.
Yeah.
Where I want you, because Cash had it for a bit.
Yeah. It's not like my first thought isn't get in front of the net, it's
exactly
to be a player.
And so it's more this drill we do more for that thought.
Okay.
Outside your comfort zone. To get out of the way. Hey, and then you buried it.
I thought she was gonna shoot faster than that. So I was like coming that way, and I thought she was gonna shoot faster.
I'm just that much smarter than her that I thought I knew she should shoot before she even knew she should shoot. Anyways, nice job. That was good. I think at one point we were 4-for-4. Like we went 4 times and we scored 4 goals. That's exciting. It's like, good job. Kels is filling in.
Yeah,
Junior. <Yeah.
laughs>
Good job, D. Sam. Sam. If you're ever right here on a 3-on-1 with the puck, and you don't shoot that, I will cut you.
Is that not right? Because that's what Monty always told us, to wait for the shot to sneak in the switch.
No, it's fine. I just get concerned that after the shot's taken, she's gonna move first.
Yeah.
So I would say if you could get on her stick, God,
okay.
Get on that. We'll be with the whiff. Bobby. It is. I think that's your fourth whiff on the day. Well, you're always in a good spot, so let's look at the positive.
The women's hockey team is back in action Friday at 4 p.m. as they host New England College. To learn more about the women's ice hockey team, check out beaconsathletics.com or give them a follow on Twitter at UMBW Hockey. For Inside the Beacon, I'm Haley Dutton.
Beacons have a 10-point lead here over Bridgewater State at halftime. As we look at the halftime stats, big focus on the defense for UMass Boston. Tremendous job holding Bridgewater State to that poor shooting percentage of 8 for 23, and then getting those defensive rebounds. Beacons out-rebounding the Bears by 12. That's really the biggest difference on this game when you look at it on paper. Beacons aren't shooting a great percentage either, but they've had those 5 extra field goal attempts because of all those rebounds. Beacons have gotten 14 extra possessions because of those rebounds. They've only had one more turnover than the Bears. So all that adds up to a lot more chances to go to work offensively for UMass Boston, a 10-point lead for the Beacons, who have pretty smoothly led throughout that entire first half by a comfortable margin. We look at the individual team leaders here at halftime for UMass Boston. It's a pretty balanced scoring effort so far. 6 points apiece for Katie Matthew and Kirsten Morrison, and 7 for Grace Geary, who leads the way. How about 8 rebounds for Olivia Murphy, who had 24 rebounds last year against Bridgewater State, on pace for 16 rebounds tonight. And Grace Geary also has a couple assists. It's been Chanel Melton and Rihanna Page, and really not a whole lot else for Bridgewater State. Melton with 9 points to lead it for the Bears, and then Rihanna Page with 6 points, rest of the team, which is 6 total points for Bridgewater State. Take a look at the men's basketball highlights from their last time out, an 83-78 loss to Eastern Connecticut State. Remember, the men play Bridgewater State coming up at 7:30. Here's that look at the last time they were on the floor here at the Clark.
Sean Khalifa, man. Toe change. Money's the motivation, money's the conversation. You on vacation, we getting paid, so we on vacation. I did it for the fam. It's whatever we had to do, it's just who I am. Yeah, it's the life I chose. Gunshots in the dark, one eye closed. And we got it cooking like a one-eye stove. You can catch me kissing my girl with both eyes closed. Yeah, perfecting my passion, thanks for asking. Couldn't slow down, so we had to crash it. You use plastic, we bout cash. I see some people ahead that we gon' pass, yeah. I never fear death or dying. I only fear never trying. I am whatever I am. Only God can judge me now. One shot, everything rides on tonight. Even if I've got 3 strikes, I'ma go for it. This moment, we own it.
Be the same ones that I doubt with. Put it all out on the line with. If you're looking for me, you can find wit in the new car or the crown whip. My new broad does a fine chick in the weather squad. I'm down with. Ain't no way around it. What you say? Tell me what you say. Working hard, repping for my dogs. Do this every day. Taking off, looking out for all. Making sure we ball like the mob. All you do is call. Catch you if you fall. I'm Khalifa.
Should be a really good game tonight between the Beacons men, who are 9-4 on the year, and the Bridgewater State men, who are 8-6. Bridgewater State had a good 81-78 win against UMass Dartmouth a bit earlier in the season. Beacons are coming in off a 13-point win over Plymouth State last time out. Time to take a look around Beaconville. Of course, that men's basketball game coming up at 7:30. Men's hockey's a bit of a rougher start to this second semester, but still ranked 11th in the country. They'll take on St. Anselm Friday at 7 p.m. And women's hockey hosts New England College 4 p.m. on Friday. That'll be a doubleheader with the women at 4 and the men at 7. Take a look at the Little East Conference scoreboard. Worcester State with a 13-8 lead over Keene State in the other MASCAC versus Little East matchup. But close game very early on still between those two schools. Take a look ahead at what's coming up for these Beacons. Back to Little East play we go. Saturday at WestCon, Tuesday at UMass Dartmouth, and then next Saturday against those aforementioned Kane State Owls. Should be a really interesting next few weeks for this Beacons club. It's sitting at 2-2 currently in the Little East standings. And really a whole lot still to play for UMass Boston. 2-2 puts them in a tie for fourth place with Western Connecticut State and with Keene State. By the end of next week, they could be anywhere as far up as first or second place with three wins. They could be as far down as seventh or sixth place with three losses, and they could fall anywhere in between. Makes a game like today important here, getting everything in order before heading back into Little East play. Beacons lead 31-21 after 20 minutes here at the Clark. After this game ends, we'll have about a 30-minute or so break, and then we'll tip things off around 7:30 between the Beacon men and the Bridgewater State men. Have that one for you as well on littleeast.tv. Beacons led in half one by 7 points from Grace Geary, and six apiece for Kirsten Morrison and Katie Matthew, who hit 2 3-pointers in the first half. Bridgewater State had 9 points from Chanel Melton, 6 points from Rihanna Page, and 4 points from Vanessa Consatio. Beacons and White get things going against a man-to-man Bridgewater State defense. Beacons were 10 of 28 from the floor in the first half. Entry down low to Morrison, doesn't get there. Melton the deflection, and just like that, turnover number 13 for UMass Boston today. Beacons defense, though, has forced 11 turnovers and held Bridgewater State to just 8 of 24 shooting. Kickball on Morrison. Inbound coming for Bridgewater State. The last 5 minutes or so of that first half actually were played at a pretty good pace. I know 31-21 doesn't sound like a track meet, but with about 5 minutes to go in the half, it was 26-11. So both offenses got it going down the stretch. Three doesn't go for Cush. Offensive board for Melton. Second chance for the Bears. Here's Boudelet, and she scores around Morrison. Nifty move by Megan Boudelet. First 2 points of half two belong to the Bears. Murphy for the answer. Gets her shot blocked and sticks with it to score. Slow offensive game for Murphy, who has just 6 points, but she does have 8 rebounds after 20 minutes of play. Beacons by 10. Geary, the interception, just jumped the passing lane and got there in front of Daigle. Long pass for Nelson. Smart play to pass up on the jumper in transition. Find Murphy inside, and the layup goes. All of a sudden, Olivia Murphy is the leading scorer for the Beacons. 4 in a row for UMass Boston. It's a 12-point lead. Beacons led by as much as 13 in half one. Boudelet kicks out. Consatio's off on the three, and a rebound right down to Geary. Rough game offensively so far for Bridgewater State. Just 1 of 7 from three. They entered today near the bottom of the country at 21% from three on the season. Held ball gives it to Bridgewater State out of the MASCAC Conference, 2-1 in the MASCAC. They are the defending MASCAC champs. Went to the NCAA tournament last year after a 16-12 regular season, and that MASCAC championship they lost in the first round. Consatio tries to chase it down at midcourt. Here's Burstyn pushing the pace to Geary as the Beacons force a 12th Bridgewater State turnover. And Burstyn gives it right back with a 14th Beacons turnover. Chelsea Saucier re-enters for Bridgewater State. We've played about 2.5 minutes in this second half. Beacons with the 12-point lead. Quick ball movement here against the 2-3 zone. A trap on Melton. She dribbles out of it and gets an easy layup to go. Beacons doubled down on Melton, but she escaped fairly easily. 11 for Chanel Melton. She leads all scorers here tonight. It's a 10-point game. Beacon's trying to put together back-to-back wins for the first time in the 2015 portion of the season. Beacons have won four of their last five games. This ball skips right out of bounds. Wins against Rhode Island College, Salve Regina, Brandeis, Eastern Connecticut State. The loss to Eastern Connecticut State, and then the win against Plymouth State last time out. Five Little East games in a row for UMass Boston coming up before diving back out of conference to play Suffolk on February 3rd right here at home. Nelson, tough move on the hook, doesn't go. She was late in the shot clock and had to put it up. Still a 10-point lead for the Beacons. Bridgewater State's made an adjustment here in half two. They are getting that ball to Boudelet at the free throw line against this 2-3 zone, but here's a turnover as Saucier was standing on the end line. In half one for Bridgewater State, it was a much more stagnant offense. Passed the ball around the perimeter over and over again and jacked up a lot of threes. Getting the ball to the free throw line is a key against the zone because it opens up backdoor cuts and a whole lot more. Courtney Mattingly calls time as a double came to Nelson right at midcourt. 30-second timeout for the Beacons. We'll step aside quickly as well. Beacons by 10 on the Beacons Broadcast Network.
Paris changed my life, and I got there through UMass. Those very specific seminal moments in Paris. The subway. A man in a tuxedo walked in, and a woman in a long gown. And it was stunning. It all hit me. It was like a lightning bolt. There was this world of beauty and style that I wanted to be a part of. That was the beginning of the journey. And that all came through the University of Massachusetts. And that was really a key moment for me. That's one of those moments you never forget.
Well, just like we started half one, a very slow start to half two as well. Through about 4 minutes, each team has scored 4 points in the second half. For the Beacons, though, that's fair game. They're up 10 points. They'll trade baskets the rest of the way if it'll get them to 9-5 on the season. Long three rattles out for Matthew, who had two in the first half. Edwards has the offensive board, and Geary travels. Another UMass Boston turnover. It's the 15th. And Geary got a technical foul. Not sure about that call. I think she was just tossing it back to the official behind her as she turned around. But the official who called the travel calls her for a technical. Alrighty. Two free throws coming on the technical for Chelsea Saucier. And then Bridgewater State will get the ball. First free throw is good. Saucier, just a 4 of 13 free throw shooter on the season, but they pick her for the technicals, and she makes them both. It's an 8-point game. Substitution for the Beacons, and Tajay Burstyn will replace Grace Geary, who heads to the bench after the technical foul. Again, not quite sure about that decision from our officials tonight. Beacons by 8, 16-10 to play. Couple free points for Bridgewater State. See if that jump starts the Bears trying to come back here and move to 9-6 on the season. Bridgewater State's 24-6 all time against UMass Boston, but the Beacons won last year by 25 points down in Bridgewater. Skip pass. It was an open look for three. Instead, an extra pass to Melton inside. Off on the layup. Rebound into the hands of Matthew. Melissa Daigle had passed up an open corner three. And Bridgewater State struggles from outside. They are just 1-for-7 today. Great collapse defensively from the Bears, who've come out trapping really aggressively with their 1-3-1 zone. Daigle, a senior from Rockland. At the top of the circle, gets it to Cush. Boudelet finds Daigle once more. Seven to shoot. Boudelet down low. It's blocked by Murphy. Boudelet on a re-trigger. And a 3-second violation called. Boudelet got blocked and then stuffed right in the center of the lane as Murphy stood tall against an 1,000-point career scorer in Megan Boudelet. Played a quarter of this second half. Beacons by 8, but they just throw it right away. Burstyn overshot Nelson, and that's quickly going to send Tajay Burstyn back to the bench as Grace Geary returns for. Courtney Mattingly talking to Tajay Burstyn over on the bench, but settling things down as the Beacons turn it over for a 17th time tonight. Open look for Cush, short. Follow doesn't go home for Paige. Ty Murphy just stood with her arms straight up. Beacons by 8, they haven't scored in about 2.5 minutes. Edwards short on the jumper. Nice move to get free, but couldn't hit. Might have anticipated contact from Melton. Here's Melton, leads all scorers with 11. Geary pesters her. Quick passing around the zone, and Nelson plays a bit of volleyball there to knock it out. 13 seconds left on the shot clock for Bridgewater State as Cush heads to the bench and Vanessa Consatio returns. Sling it inside for Boudelet. Extra pass. Paige off on the jumper. Well, she started red hot, 3 of her first 4. She has not made a shot here in half 2. Beacon still by 8. In a defensive struggle. UMass Boston shooting 36%. Bridgewater State shooting 31%. Matthew for a 3rd. 3. She's got it. Katie Matthew has 9 on 3 of 7 shooting from downtown. Beacons lead back to 11. Their largest of the game has been 13. Since it was 8-6 in the first half, Bridgewater State hasn't gotten any closer than 6 points after the Beacons went on a 14-3 run. So even though they've been hanging around, the Beacons still doing a fairly good job keeping a comfortable margin. Bridgewater State takes timeout. We'll take a timeout with them. 13-18 to play. Beacons by 11 on LittleEast.tv.
Division 3 allows you to give yourself to other things.
Having that free time allows me to pursue the things that I want to pursue.
Division 3 athletics affords students the opportunity to, you know, engage in the other interests in their campus and in their lives outside of that sport. It allows you to just be able to do everything you want to do. I wouldn't change it for the world.
Well, it hasn't been the prettiest game by any stretch of the imagination to this point, but for the Beacons, the result on the scoreboard right now looks like a work of art, a 38-27 UMass Boston lead. Beacons have that lead on the back of a pretty balanced scoring effort. 9 points for Katie Matthew on 3 3-pointers, 8 points for Olivia Murphy, 7 for Grace Geary, and 6 for Kirsten Morrison. Meanwhile, Bridgewater State has relied on Chanel Melton to score 11 of the Bears' 27 points. Beacons are holding Bridgewater State to 31% shooting, and the biggest key of this game has been the rebounding. Beacons have 31 rebounds to just 19 for the Bears. Here's Murphy heading in. Doesn't get the layup to go. Follow goes for Nelson. Mallory Nelson sticks it home. She has 4. Beacons have matched their largest lead of the game at 13. Quick pass sets up Consatio. Short on the 3. Bridgewater State's now 1 for 9 from downtown. Geary on the run out. Draws contact and 2 free throws coming. Really tough for Bridgewater State to come back from any type of sizable deficit because they just struggle so mightily from outside. Enter today shooting 21% from 3. And as hard as it is to believe, right now that percentage has gone down at just 1 for 9 today, or about 11%. A 1 of 2 trip for Geary gives the Beacons their largest lead of the game. It's a 14-point lead for UMass Boston, and Grace Geary has 8 points. Jumper, no. Paige is 0 for 3 and 1/2, 2. Follows her miss. She's 0 for 4. Missed them both on this trip. 3 for 4 in the first half, 0 for 4 and 1/2, 2. Geary drives the lane and is fouled. Consatia reached in for her second foul, and only the second on Bridgewater State in this second half. Again, there haven't been all that many fouls in this game, just 3 combined in this second half after a first half that just had 13 combined fouls. So allowed this game to be played at a pretty good pace. Geary for 3. It's short. And a defensive rebound. It's batted around. Geary crashed in to knock it free. Beacons can't save it, but hey, that's great hustle. Two different Beacons ended up on the hardwood. Courtney Mattingly loves it as she's applauding up off the bench for the Beacons. 14-point lead for UMass Boston. Here's Saucier over the timeline for Bridgewater State. Don't forget the Beacons men take on the Bridgewater State men coming up about a half hour after this one ends, right around 7:30. Thrown away by Boudelet for turnover number 17 for Bridgewater State. 35 combined turnovers between the two clubs here over the game's first 28 minutes. 35 combined turnovers, 29 combined made field goals so far. Bridgewater State needs some stops to get a run going. Beacons by 14, and in a game played at this pace with this type of defense, 14 feels like a Grand Canyon gap between these two teams. Beacons keep it into the offensive end. Entry Morrison, right block. No, too strong. Murphy gets the board on another one of those scrums right around the rim. Had no one guarding her, turned around, threw it up. No, third try, it's good. Plus one for Morrison. Well, that was kind of an oddly developing play. Beacon scrummed for that rebound. All of a sudden, Murphy realized nobody was guarding her at all, and she just kind of flicked it towards the hoop. And then Morrison pounded it home on the third try. Free throw good for Kirsten Morrison. She has 9. Beacons by 17. Far and away their largest lead of this game. Boudelet subs out. Right back to Jessica Sidler into the game for Bridgewater State. Tough jumper and a foul called. Stephanie DeSantis, the junior from Walpole, got popped on the way through. Walpole, Massachusetts, the hometown of the wonderful sports information director here at UMass Boston, Dave Wahlberg. Here's Stephanie DeSantis' free throw, and it is good. DeSantis, a junior, averages only about 13 minutes a game, 2 points a game on the season. One of two trip, but Melton grabs the offensive board and draws a foul. Now the 5'9 Melton worked around the 6'2 Morrison to grab that one. The one of two on the line stopped what was a 7-0 Beacons run. Still, it's a 16-point UMass Boston lead as Murphy gets her hand on the pass. Foul, by the way, was on Mallory Nelson, and it's her third, but just the third on the Beacons here in this second half. UMass Boston by 16. So the Beacons look to go to 4-1 in 2015 and 5-1 in their last six games. Geary might have gotten away with yanking down DeSantis. Beacons pick it up and draw a foul. Bridgewater State foul goes on Rihanna Page, her third, fourth on the Bears. Beacons get a new shot clock and possession at midcourt, up by 16. Trying to put this game away at the midway point of half two. One more run for UMass Boston could probably seal this one up. A Bridgewater State run the other game could make this one interesting. Murphy goes right to the rim. Double-double for Olivia Murphy. 10 points on the night. Almost a double-digit rebound at halftime. She had 8. And we have a foul called. Foul on Katie Matthew is her first. Murphy now, 10 points, 10 rebounds for the Beacons. Jumper was too strong. Beacons have the offensive board, leading by a game-high 18. Geary settles it down for UMass Boston. Beacons back to Little East play for five straight conference games starting Saturday. Fourth three of the night rattles just out for Matthew. Offensive board for Edwards. She is headed to the free throw line for two. How close is Katie Matthew to hitting her fourth three-pointer? That one touched every part of the rim a couple of times before hopping out. Two free throws for Katrina Edwards, a sophomore forward from Springfield. Well, we featured her before the game. She's had herself a pretty nice game. This couple of free throws gives her a chance to get to five, and now a chance to get to 6 points after she makes the first. Brittany Moore returns to the game for the Beacons. She'll spell Olivia Murphy. It's been a busy stretch for UMass Boston of games every other day. They played Tuesday here on Thursday, and they'll play again on Saturday. So wouldn't be surprised with a 19-point lead to see Courtney Mattingly use her bench fairly liberally here down the stretch to try and keep her squad fresh heading into an important Little East game on Saturday at Western Connecticut State. That's a travel on Melton. And here comes a timeout for Bridgewater State. This game's getting away from the Bears and their 18th year head coach, Bridget Casey. And we'll get away for just a bit here on LittleEast.tv.
UMass Boston was my first choice because when I came to the campus, I saw that there was a lot of diversity. There's a lot of people. Here there is a lot of international students, so it's really cool to meet people from different countries, different parts of the world. I'm Julia Murphy. I'm from Canton, Massachusetts.
I'm Olivia Murphy. I'm from Canton, Massachusetts.
We're sisters.
We're sisters.
I play volleyball and she plays basketball. Here they have a freshman success community. So each major has their own community that you can join as a freshman, and you take classes with them, you do study groups with them. So it was really helpful getting to know people in your major right away.
So in health exercise sciences, we have an internship at the end, so it's so much better to have like an advisor helping you out, like telling you which classes to choose.
That's got to look at the Murphy sisters. Olivia with 10 points, 10 rebounds today for the Beacons. Her sister Julia, a volleyball all-star here for UMass Boston. Beacons lead by a game-high 19, less than 10 minutes to go in a non-conference game here against Bridgewater State. One issue has been turnovers. That's number 20. But Bridgewater State can't capitalize in transition. Layup didn't go for DeSantis, who has it now in the corner. Beacons go back to Little East play in 2 days. Road trip to Danbury, Connecticut and Western Connecticut State. Run out in transition, and Matthew gets to double figures. 11 points for Katie Matthew, Beacons by 21. It's going to be about a three-hour trip for UMass Boston to Western Connecticut State. By far the longest trip in the conference. Double dribble on Melton is a turnover. And so for UMass Boston with a tough trip ahead and now a 21-point lead, there's a pretty deep bench that hasn't seen the floor yet today that I would not be surprised to see start to empty out as this game goes along. It's a 1 p.m. game at Western Connecticut State as well, so rather early start to the day on Saturday for the Beacons. Probably roll out of the Clark around 8 o'clock on Saturday morning. UMass Boston by 21. Here's Geary, who's had another nice game at point, not near her 27 from last time out, but there's three on the way, no good. Hops out. She's got 8 points, four assists today, and she's continued to run the tempo pretty well for the Beacons. Really, this is the type of game, if you're Courtney Mattingly, where you're pretty pleased with how balanced the team has been. 11 points for Matthew, 10 for Murphy, 9 for Morrison, 8 for Geary. When you have that many different capable scoring threats, turns you into a very tough team to defend. Pass down low, overshot Boudelet. It's a turnover for Saucier, and it's Bridgewater State's 22nd turnover of this game. Bridgewater State is shooting just 25% from the floor. Bears have just two field goals and 7 points in the first 12 minutes of this second half. And they've turned it over 22 times. Geary wants a three. Give her a three. Second of the night for Grace Geary. She's to double figures with 11 as her hot play continues. Put a real hurt in her season average over the past month or so, jumping up from high single digits to now 13 and a half points a game. Long three didn't go, and boy, it's tough from outside for Bridgewater State. They're 1-for-10 today, and now down around 20% on the season. Geary right to the rim. Oh, what a move. Grace Geary has 13, and the last five for the Beacons. It's a 26-point lead for UMass Boston. Beacons led by just 10 at halftime. Extra pass sets up Melton down low. Over Moore, she scores. Yeah, Chanel Melton, and really that's about it for Bridgewater State today. 13 of her team's 30 points. Beacons still by 24. Moore looking for an answer inside. Feeds Geary for another three. Edwards battles for the rebound, and Boudelet takes it away. Home run pass ahead for Daigle. Beacons recover well defensively. Boudelet's foul. That's a reach-in on Matthew. That's too bad that Matthew ends up picking up a foul there, because she played really good defense at the start of that possession to get back and stop what looked like it was going to be a fast break. Substitutions for UMass Boston. Raven Kelsey has entered the game along with Jamie Ballou, freshman from Foxborough, and Kelsey is a freshman from Boston. Beacons have played that 2-3 zone all game long and made life extremely difficult on these Bridgewater State Bears. Melton walked. 23 turnovers, and all that can do is make Coach Casey on the sideline stick her head into her hands. It's been that kind of night for the 18th year head coach and her squad. It's a really frustrating offensive night for the Bears. Entry to Moore, layup is good. Beacons by 26. Look at Geary, pressure all over Daigle. Entry does not go for Boudelet. Rebound out of bounds off of Bridgewater State. Here's Ballou holding straight away. Nelson's jumper a hair too strong. Rebound pops straight into the hands of DeSantis. Pushes the pace with Daigle to the rim, and a foul on Geary, who thought she got the clean block. She had to try to guard her reaction a bit after already picking up a technical foul, but you could tell from the facial expression that the freshman Grace Geary thought she had that one crystal clean. Two free throws for the senior, Melissa Daigle, who has not scored yet today. 77% free throw shooter on the season, and she hits the first. Beacons by 25. Rihanna Page returns for Bridgewater State. Beacons bring in Chantel Jordan, sophomore from Brockton, who was a high school teammate of Chanel Melton on Bridgewater State. Both free throws go for Daigle. Beacons lead back to 24 points. UMass Boston has outscored Bridgewater State 25-11 in the first 14 minutes of half two. This is Raven Kelsey. Jordan, the jumper, too strong. Strong rebound for Cush, who hits the hardwood. And Bridgewater State goes out of bounds as Daigle hustled after it. Remember to stay with us for the men's hoops game coming up after this one closes things up. Should start right around 7:30. Beacons and Bridgewater State Bears men, be a really good matchup. Beacons are 9-4, the Bears are 8-6, and they've been pretty evenly matched when they've played the past few seasons. Beacons lead the series 17-14 all time, but are just 2-9 in the last 11 games. Bridgewater State won by 12 last year when those two teams went head-to-head. Foul on Bridgewater State. It's the sixth already on the Bears. The Beacons will be shooting free throws the rest of the way. Moore gets the jumper to go. Brittany Moore has six here in the second half. Beacons back up by 26. Drive and dish ends up with a turnover. Ballou pushes the pace. And Geary smartly backs it out. Still 20 seconds to work with on the shot clock. Out of foul and a 1-1 coming for the Beacons. Melissa Daigle with the hand check. That sends Jamie Ballou to the free throw line. Ballou, a freshman from Foxborough. Her hometown will be hopping this weekend. AFC Championship game between the Colts and the Patriots on Sunday. Had a foul called off the rebound on the missed free throw. So Brittany Moore is headed right back to the free throw line. Bridgewater State's eighth foul and the third on Chanel Melton. Geary leaves the game. Tajay Burstyn re-enters. UMass Boston with just one starter on the floor. That's Burstyn. And then Jordan Moore, Kelsey, and Ballou with a 26-point lead and only 4:55 remaining. That free throw hops around on the rim and out. Beacons go 0 for 2 on the trip. Bridgewater State pushes the pace and turns it over again. That's the 27th Bridgewater State turnover. Already 15 here in half two. Courtney Mattingly still coaching hard on the sidelines. This is a chance for some of the players that don't get a whole lot of playing time to work things out together on the floor against an opponent for a whole 5 minutes or so. Moore has it ripped away from her, and a jump ball is called. Keep the arrow with the Beacons, and 28 seconds on the shot clock. Jillian Sedler returns to the game for Bridgewater State. We've got 4:20 to play. The Beacons up by 26. Busted open an 11-point halftime game to take this 26-point lead. In fact, it was a 10-point lead at halftime. Offensive foul on Moore on the screen. Really balanced effort today for UMass Boston offensively. Nobody scored more than 13. That was Grace Geary who led the way with 13 points. 11 for Katie Matthew, a double-double for Olivia Murphy, 10 points, 10 rebounds. And Kirsten Morrison chipped in 9 points. Morrison and Murphy have played very limited minutes as well to keep themselves fresh for Western Connecticut State on Saturday. It's an important Little East game coming up for UMass Boston. Could have been a travel there on Sidler. Instead, they'll reset the offense. In the corner, a pump fake from Christine Curran. Gets it down low, and Sedler scores. That's two for Jillian Sedler. Makes it a 24-point game. Beacons and Western Connecticut State are two of three teams tied for fourth place. So with a win on Saturday, the Beacons would at worst be in fourth. With a loss, they would at best sit in fifth place. Beacons continue that strong 2-3 zone. Three on the way for Curran. Well short. Raven Kelsey gets the rebound. How about 1-for-10 on threes for Bridgewater State as the Beacons turn it over for a 22nd time. More substitutions for the Beacons. Marina Kelly out of Whitman, Massachusetts is into the game. Beacons also enter in Cheyenne Wellington, a sophomore from Springfield, as we have a traveling violation called. So it's Jordan, Kelsey, Wellington, Kelly, and Ballou. Kelly out of Whitman, Massachusetts, Whitman-Hanson Regional High School. Wellington, long two, it's good. Cheyenne Wellington cans the two-pointer. Beacons by 26. Push the pace for Rihanna Page, and that's a foul. give the foul to Jordan. Two free throws coming for Bridgewater State. Brianna Page had a really hot start. She was 3 for her first 4, but she's 0 for 5 from the field here in the second half, and she misses the free throw. Free throw halfway down and out, and a rebound for Raven Kelsey. The outlet to Marina Kelly, who was a key cog on the Beacon's soccer squad this season as well as a freshman out of Whitman-Hanson just down the road. Wellington has her pocket picked. That'll be one area where I'm sure Courtney Mattingly will still have some concern. 23 turnovers for the Beacons today as Kelsey gets a steal. But UMass Boston has won the turnover battle. They forced 29. Kelly to the front court where she'll slow things down. Beacons have shot 41% from the field, just 27% for Bridgewater State. An excellent defensive performance today for UMass Boston in its 2-3 zone and a real confidence builder heading into Saturday's game. How about the move by Ballou? A crossover got her free, and she sticks it home. Beacons match their largest lead of the game at 28 points. Now for Bridgewater State, they'll need to lick their wounds quickly here because they're back in action Saturday in a MASCAC game. Jump ball give the possession to Bridgewater State. Bridgewater State plays a home game against Worcester State in 2 days on Saturday. Important MASCAC game if Bridgewater State wants to get back to the NCAA tournament like they did last year with a conference win. That's Jamie Ballou's first foul, ninth on UMass Boston. Number 21, Megan Iannaro, a freshman from Ashland, Massachusetts, goes to the free throw line and hits the front end of the 1-1. So both sides have emptied the bench here. We got about 90 seconds left, and then we'll have about a half an hour delay between the men's game, or this finish of this game and the men's game, which would start around 7:30. Beacons and Bridgewater State, and what should be a really good one. Hope you stay with us for that one here on LittleEast.tv and the Beacons Broadcast Network. Step back. Long two is good for Ballou. Right on the line, was close to a three. It's the largest lead of the game for the Beacons at 29 points. That hand check foul on Wellington with a 29-point lead. Last thing you really want to be doing is extend the game and send your opponent to the free throw line. Two free throws coming for Stephanie DeSantis, junior from Walpole. And the first free throw is good. That is some kind of free throw routine for DeSantis, who bounced the ball about 17 times before taking the free throw. DeSantis misses the second free throw, rebound batted around, and the Beacons take possession. If this scoreline holds, it would be the lowest point total allowed by UMass Boston this season. They gave up 38 against Simmons College. Hard drive, layup doesn't go, but DeSantis will have a chance to match that 38-point total if she can hit either of these free throws. Beacon still by 28. DeSantis is just 1-for-4 from the free throw line today. She hits the first free throw. Previewing that men's basketball matchup, which will come your way in about a half an hour, Beacon's Carl Joseph has been so hot since the start of the season, scored 25 last time out, still averaging more than 20 a game. Meanwhile, Bridgewater State has a much more balanced offense, led by two big fellas down low, Kyle Gibson and Michael Lofton, both average better than 15 points a game. Should be a really fun matchup between two very strong teams. Key to that game may lie in how the Beacons rebound against a Bridgewater State team that struggles to get to the glass. Runner for Ballou doesn't go. Batted out off of Bridgewater State. And the Bears will have one more possession. Down 27 with a chance to surpass that 38-point mark with a bucket. So at least they wouldn't have scored the fewest points against the Beacons all season. Bounce pass intercepted by Kelsey. She lobs it forward. And here's Kelly to run it to the corner. Shot clock is off. And the Beacons pass up on the shot for the time being. Kelsey feeds Jordan. Here's Kelly. Beacons are going to run through their motion offense. They do not need to shoot if they don't want to here. Ballou overthrows Moore down low. One more chance for Bridgewater State. Three seconds left. One final heave on the way. Well off. And the Beacons win 64-37. Fewest points allowed of the season for UMass Boston as they force 30 turnovers and hold Bridgewater State to 26% shooting. Beacons move to 9-5 on the season. They're back to Little East play for five games in a row starting Saturday. The Bears fall to 8-7. They'll dive back into MASCAC play. We'll step aside for a bit when we come back. We'll break down the stats from this game, and we'll talk to Beacons head coach Courtney Mattingly as well here on LittleEast.tv.
Hi, my name is Carl Joseph. I currently a criminal justice major. I'm a senior. I am from Brockton, Massachusetts. In basketball, I play small forward slash power forward, and in track, I'm a high jumper. Basketball has always been my first love. The favorite part was probably our win over MIT. Like that was tremendous. I almost came to tears just from where the program has come from where I first came here to where we are now. It's just amazing, and I love it. Honestly, I was recruited for basketball. My high school coach actually emailed the track coach here, and she walked into the gym one day, and it was just like, here, you, come talk to me. And I was on the track team. It really wasn't much of a choice. It was a great honor my freshman year just being able to become an All-American, finishing fourth in my first ever national championship meet. It was quite the time of my life. My junior year, we received our LEC championship rings from our sophomore year. Coming in to my freshman year at UMass, I was able to witness the volleyball team win their championship and the soccer team, and the only thing that I really wanted was a ring of my own.
Here's Joseph knifing through.
Funny thing is, I actually work here as well. I am one of the Zamboni drivers to our men's and women's hockey teams, and that's what I do for part-time. Being a student here at campus, I can honestly tell you, is quite different from anywhere else you could possibly go. Just the student body here is amazing. I mean, the teachers are amazing. All the teachers that I've had never hesitated to help me out in any way that they could have, from extra help to me going into their offices just to talk about what's going on in the classes and to keep me on track. What I want to do when I graduate, I want to go into the police force for a little bit and ultimately end up either working for the Department of Homeland Security or the Department of ICE. It's definitely possible to be a two-sport athlete here at UMass Boston. It's just going to take a little bit of hard work.
My name is Allie Greenberg. I'm an ice hockey player here. I'm a junior majoring in human services, and I'm part of the Key for Hope Foundation. We recycle the keys and stock food pantries with the money. I wanted to bring this foundation to the athletic department, and I believe we can end hunger starting at UMass Boston. I got started with the Key for Hope Foundation due to my father. He's the one who founded this program.
I said, what can I do with a classroom environment giving back? And everybody's got an old key.
and keys are made of brass, and brass is a recyclable commodity. And thinking about how many children are in a school system and how far we can go with taking this to do something right for humanity, I started a foundation called Key for Hope, feeding others with the collecting of keys. In 2.5 years, we collected over 500,000 keys. And I'm excited about this whole opportunity because you know what? One key may not seem like much to most people, but when you collect the masses of keys that we've collected, it shows that there is an ability for people to get together and create what I'm considering our hunger fighting opportunity.
I'm Elizabeth Glavin, sophomore business management major from Edina, Minnesota. I love being a part of this volleyball team. Volleyball is what brought me to UMass Boston. I looked at our recruiting website one last time and saw UMass Boston on it, came out for a visit the next week, and it kind of hit all the boxes that I was looking for. In a good city, good academic school, good volleyball program, it had everything I wanted. Although it was far away from home, I knew this is where I wanted to be. Winning 6 back-to-back LEC titles is really a dynasty, I think, and Terry has really focused hard on recruiting and building this dynasty and continuing to build a program that can continue to win championships, and it's really lucky to be a part of something this great. Last year, I was the Little East Conference Defensive Player of the Year, All-Conference Second Team, NCAA Regional MVP of the Regional Tournament, ABC All-Region Honorable Mention, and New England Women's Volleyball Association All-Rookie Team and Honorable Mention. I think my favorite game would have to be playing in the Regional Championship last year. We played against a really good Williams team, and I think that match, we started off a little shaky and lost the first set we've lost in the whole playoff season, and I think that kind of shook us a little bit. We came back firing and we're ready to go those next couple games. Our coaches are bringing in a lot of really strong girls who want to make a commitment and make an impact in this program, and I think that is why we're continuing to do well and we'll continue to do well for the next few years. Being a student here has been really awesome as well. I've recently started taking more of my business classes and found that's a good choice and a good fit for me. And eventually I hope to open my own business and kind of be successful and do what I love at the end of the day.
Beacons close out a 64-37 win here against Bridgewater State University. UMass Boston taking care of business with that really strong second half. Take a look at the final statistics for UMass Boston. Out-rebounding Bridgewater State by 11. Look at those other defensive numbers, though. 30 turnovers forced. 12 of 46 from the floor for Bridgewater State. That's only about 25%. And Beacons held them to just 1 for 11 from three-point range as well. UMass Boston gave it away 24 times, but did shoot the ball fairly well from the field and got balanced scoring all the way throughout. Take a look at the team leaders today for the Beacons as well. Grace Geary with 13 points in a balanced effort. 10 rebounds for Olivia Murphy, who had a double-double with 10 points as well. 4 assists for Geary, 4 for Burston. Chanel Melton basically did all the scoring for Bridgewater State, as a team otherwise really couldn't get things going. Taking a look ahead at what's next for UMass Boston. It's all Little East, at least for the next few weeks. They've got 5 consecutive Little East matchups coming up, starting with Western Connecticut State, that long, tough road trip in just 2 days. Important stretch for the Beacons as they try to elevate themselves to the top of the Little East Conference standings. Currently, they sit in a tie for 4th at 2-2 in Little East play. We'll step aside quickly here and we'll come back with an interview with Beacon head coach Courtney Mattingly. And then we'll have the Beacon men, the Bridgewater State men, coming up on littleeast.tv.
The University of Massachusetts Boston. It's just minutes from downtown, and the Princeton Review calls it one of the best values in the country. A nationally recognized institution of academic excellence and research, UMass Boston offers more than 150 undergraduate and graduate programs, 16 Division III sports, and more than 100 student organizations. To learn more about the opportunities waiting for you at UMass Boston, visit in person or online. UMass Boston, a research university with a teaching soul.
Something I discovered in myself is that if I have a goal, then I can accomplish it.
It's a well-rounded experience.
At a Division III school, you're primarily a student athlete, so the school is really shaped around you developing yourself as a complete individual.
It helps a lot that you have
a family with your team that can guide you.
Today, we want you on our team.
The University of Massachusetts Boston, with its scenic oceanfront campus, easily accessible to downtown Boston, is recognized as a model of excellence for urban public universities. 16 NCAA Division III sports are part of the more than 100 student organizations that create an engaging campus life in America's biggest and best college town. UMass Boston, Boston's urban public research university for the 21st century.
Back with the Beacons head coach Courtney Mattingly after the 27-point win. I think, coach, you got to start with defense tonight. Lowest points allowed all season long, about 25% shooting and 30 turnovers forced. What did you think of the effort?
I thought it was okay. I thought it was better in the second half. We did a better job of communicating, staying with cutters, and being a little bit more physical. The first half, we sort of, you know, just let them go wherever they want, cut through the paint, slices up a little bit. And we challenged them to play a little bit more physical in the second half. And I think they did a better job of that. And we were, again, the first half, this has been a problem with us at the start of games. In the first half, it's the fourth game in a row where, you know, we started slow. You know, and I'm trying to impress upon them and preach and reach them, you know, especially heading to WestCon on Saturday. It's a tough place to play to begin with. And then, you know, you can't start slow against good teams, against conference teams, and you know, we've been getting away with it, but I don't know how. But
offensively today was a pretty balanced scoring output with five different players to score at least 9 points. Is that what you're looking for as a coach?
We are. I mean, it's one of those things where, you know, for the last couple of years, teams have really, you know, have really keyed in on our bigs, doubled our bigs, played off of our guards, you know, denied fronting our bigs and sending the weak side guard low side. And it's important that our guards are threats and they're ready to make plays, make shots. And, you know, knock on wood, you know, right now we have some guards that are making plays and you know, making some shots. When players make shots, coaches look good.
Sorry about that, coach. You mentioned the WestCon game a little while ago. Obviously, it's a tough turnaround to go all the way to Danbury in a couple of days. What do you expect out of that tough trip and then the five-game Little League stretch coming up?
I don't know. We never, you know, Kim and I, the head coach at WestCon, always joke we never play well at each other's gyms. And, you know, WestCon is notoriously a really challenging place to play. You know, we're going to preach to them. We're going to talk to them. We're going to do whatever we can. You know, my seniors are going to talk, and they're going to do some different stuff, and hopefully we'll be ready to go. It's a huge game for us. Every conference game is, but especially going to WestCon right now.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck on Saturday, and we'll see you here again in a couple of weeks.
Thank you.
That's Coach. After the 27-point win today for the Beacons, they move to 9-5 on the season with a really solid defensive performance here at the Clark Athletic Center. Men's basketball coming up in about 10 minutes here on LittleEast.tv as well. A couple thank yous to pass out for our broadcast here in game number one of a doubleheader. Our production crew, thank you to the directors and to our cameraman and producers as well. director and producer overall, Seth Arensky. Jose Pena also pushing the right buttons over there, at least most of the time. And then camera operators Ron Augustine, Brian Faglia, and Charles LaPaglia. Hey, don't go really anywhere. You'll have to click on the new link on Beacons Athletics for the men's basketball game, but it's coming up in 10 minutes, Beacons and Plymouth State. So real simple, go to beaconsathletics.com, click on the live video link for the Beacons men's basketball game against Bridgewater State, and we'll be right back here in a couple of minutes for a good matchup tonight between Bridgewater State and UMass Boston. Women's game final, Beacons win by 27, 64, 37 to move to 9-5 on the year. You watched it on littleeast.tv.